And the Colonel's daughter smiled on him as well. She was nearly 21. And arrangements had begun to celebrate her birthday with a ball. He wrote to ask what present she would like from Mad Carew. They met next day as he dismissed the squad. And jestingly she told him that nothing else would do but the little green eye of the god. On the night before the dance, Mad Carew seemed in a trance. They chopped him as they puffed on their cigars. But for once he failed to smile and stood alone a while, and then went out into the night beneath the stars. He returned before the dawn with his shirt and his tunic torn, and a gash across his temple, dripping red. He was patched up right away and then slept through all the day. But the Colonel's daughter watched beside his bed. He woke at last and asked if she would bring his tunic through. She did so, and he thanked her with a nod. Then bade her search the pockets, saying, "That's from Mad Carew." 'Twas the little green eye of the god. She upbraided poor Carew in the way that women do. Though both her eyes were strangely hot and wet, she would not take the stone. And Mad Carew was left alone with the jewel that he'd chanced his life to get. The boar was at its height on that still and tropic night. She thought of him and hastened to his room.
The song we're going to play is a delight. None of you will ever have heard it before unless you've been following us around the countryside. It's called An Aching in My Heart. And it's written by some lovely boys and girls.
Lovely boys?
The uncle met.
Yes, I met them. They're all lovely.
Nice to meet them.
I do. I meet lovely boys and girls all the time, and they wrote this song called An Aching in My Heart. It features the dirty Dr. Jacko. But before we get there, we want to invite the younger members of the audience and those of you with horns in their hands, to come down to the front and sit at our feet.
Please.
If you'd like to come forward, let's please come forward. Could I have one of your uniforms? They can join in. Actually, yes. We should get one of them.
in specialists. I'm sure they know.
We would indeed.
I'll go and get one.
There's only one left. The Vikings are scared. Call yourself Vikings.
They conquered Britain. Now you can conquer the beer tent. Yes. With Sir Squacko, the mighty prince of porridge. Here. Name of Yakazar, he of the mighty horn, ladies and gentlemen.
Yay!
We'll sing for you with the Prince of Porridge, that well-known Viking drinking song. I do like to be beside the seaside.
Heart all day, all day, all day. I have
from the sea, they become frightfully sad.
That's brilliant.
Look how sad these pierrots are.
Sound.
like a mayor of Planet Funny.
Yes.
There are three stickers for the young and young at heart.
Many stickers.
You may think yourself a Viking. You may think that you're a St. John's ambulance person. What you all are peer or rotter. Say so on a sticker on either bit
thing. In my uncle's garden, ladies and gentlemen, there are many, many delights.
Yes. Just because it's Sunday, Doctor, come on.
Right. Well, we shall be back here at 1 o'clock. And at 4 o'clock,
and in between times, in between times we shall be all over the place as usual.
But now is the time to say goodbye. In fact,
now is the time to say
you're impeding yourself.
I can't help it. Now is the time to heal the sky.
Remember this.
Now is the time to wear the wings. Until we meet again.
Microwave!
Microwave!
And on your feet?
Microwave!
He's got computers on his feet.
And this? What's this? He doesn't know.
Yes, they are. Okay. Want me tea over now?
All day.
Thank you.
time has come to change the scene yet again.